Wait, why are we in a movie? Isn't this a project video? Let's go forward a bit. Well, hello, ladies and gentlemen of my social studies class. We are gathered here today to talk about a major issue of labor in the US society. Now, out of all the amazing topics in the list that our amazing teacher, Ms. Cohen, gave us, and all the topics that I looked up online, I have today decided to talk about this.
Our breaking news this hour, the auto worker strike.
The United Auto Workers, we have.
United Auto Workers Union, the nation's largest auto union.
The United Auto Workers Union's.
The United Auto Workers Union has expanded.
UAW workers have been on strike since September 15th.
We want fair economic and social justice for our members. That's what this is all about.
It's a shame on them, and what they're saying is complete BS.
Workers, the union has been demanding higher wages and benefits, including more paid time off, pensions, and an increase in retiree pay.
We just want our fair share, plain and simple.
In its proper place, because that's where...
Now, you're wondering, what is going on? What is a UAW, you know? What's with all these protests? And most importantly, why is this lady so angry? Now, to answer all your questions, we have to go back a bit. So, let's go back to the beginning.
God named the man Adam.
Whoa, okay, I think we went a bit too far back. I meant the start of the UAW. So let's go back forward. Okay, now this man right here is a 56-year-old Sean Fain, who's the most recently elected and current president of the UAW, which is an American labor union and represents all auto workers, and was founded in 1935, Detroit, Michigan. Now, you might be wondering, when and how all of this happened? Has it had any success? And why is it still considered a very big issue? Well, you better put on your seatbelts and get ready, ladies and gentlemen, because we're about to go down a crazy rabbit hole. In May of 1935, the United Automobile Workers organized its first convention in Detroit under the sponsorship of American Federation of Labor, which then went on to establish the United Automobile Workers of America, the first international union under the AFL. While the UAW had a vision of a union that included all skilled and unskilled automobile workers, the AFL was opposed to the idea of having to manage the masses of unskilled workers, which mainly at that time consisted of immigrants. But then in the April of 1936, a lot of rebellion workers rose against their then president due to his lack of experience, who was a 33-year-old Francis J. Dillon, causing his removal and their discontinuation with the AFL. The UAW then went on to join other industrial unions in the Committee of the Industrial Organizations, declaring itself a permanent independent federation and a rival of the AFL. Now, the humanitarian purpose this whole union served was to go against the horrible work conditions auto workers had, the power given to very strict supervisors who hired and fired for no reason and even controlled bathroom breaks. Following the effect of the Great Depression in the market, they were demanded to meet higher quotas and increase production speed. Now, after the UAV joined the CIO, the union experienced significant growth all over the country. The CIO also provided support for the organizing efforts, so it made it a lot easier. Now, this brought significant success, which continues to this day for the representing group, caused them to have a lot more recognition by auto companies because of the fact that they had the right to refuse unfair labor, they got better wages and benefits, and also got huge improvement on their working conditions. But even so, many auto companies were still not giving in, so that's when the strikes came through. You're supposed to roll back the big music. There we go, alright.
Solidarity forever, for the union makes us strong!
Negotiations between the United Auto Workers Union and the so-called Big Three Detroit car manufacturers are set to continue over the weekend as the two sides continue their face-off in the largest American labor action in decades. 12,700 UAW members stopped working Friday at three factories belonging to General Motors, Ford Motor, and Chrysler's parent.
That's a lot of angry people like this lady before. But did they get what they all wanted? Well, yes and no. Back in January 1st, 1937, when the first strike happened, the main goal was to get better working conditions and not just focused on better wages. But ever since their first ever deal's improvement, they have been shifting towards getting better and higher pay contracts. So how does this affect the prices in the market, and more importantly, the general public? Well, since 1937, the price of an average car has had a 260% increase, while the wage of a UAW worker has had a 75% increase. So the same thing that once auto companies bullied away is now being used as an excuse for more media attention and also increased margins. And the same thing that once started for a humanitarian and unfair treatment reasons is now only focused on more greed for money. That's one of the main reasons why unions are now welcomed by auto companies and not pushed away like they used to be. And it's safe to say that it has not had many benefits for the general public like it had for the two main sides.